As we know, the Apostle Paul was a missionary on the move. And there were different events that led Paul to go to Thessalonica. His heart was actually set on revisiting the churches in Asia Minor that he established on his first missionary journey. Around 50 AD, Paul went to Philippi, a small town that did not have a synagogue. Without a synagogue, Paul was left without his usual forum for preaching and teaching. In Philippi, he did stop and teach and preach, but his work was opposed, and he was greatly humiliated, and he was beaten. Yet, a church was founded. The resistance and the physical punishment that he endured forced Paul to leave Philippi probably sooner than he would have liked. And after leaving Philippi, Paul passed through Amphipolis and Apollonia. These towns also had no synagogue. And I think Paul took this as a sign from God to keep moving, because he didn't stay there. He kept moving on and ended up in Thessalonica, the largest city in the area, and it did have a synagogue. And Paul proceeded to teach and preach there. We learn from the book of Acts, chapter 16 and 17, that Silas and Timothy were with Paul in Thessalonica. Luke had been with them in Philippi, but he stayed back. And other men joined Paul in Thessalonica. So he wasn't there as a lone ranger. There was a team effort going in Thessalonica. Paul's length of stay in Thessalonica could have been anywhere from the length of 3 Sabbaths, which would have been about 3 weeks, to a few months. Because we read in the book of Philippians, chapter 4 and verse 16, that the church in Philippi, a small church, on more than one occasion, sent money to Paul in Thessalonica. The churches were about 100 miles apart. And that journey in Paul's time would have been a lengthy one. More than 3 weeks would have elapsed in order for them to have sent monetary support more than one time. So we can infer that he was probably there longer than 3 weeks, but probably not more than a few months. Paul left Thessalonica by night because there was a riot at the house he was staying. Paul stirred things up. And he left there and he went on his journey to Berea. However, the church in Thessalonica continued. They continued in ministry in spite of opposition. Paul continued on his travels. As we know, there was a third missionary journey, and actually what is considered in some ways a fourth missionary journey. Paul wrote 1 Thessalonians around 52 AD, and most likely he was in Corinth when he wrote. He wrote to cover basically 4 points. First, he wanted to let the folks back in Thessalonica know that he was taking joy in the fact that the church was doing well and was growing. He wanted to defend his ministry against those who still were opposing him, even though he had left town, and also to uphold the conversion of the Thessalonians. He wrote to reassure the Thessalonians about what happened to other believers at the time of their deaths. And then finally, in a way only Paul can do, he just wanted to tidy up some loose ends about other moral and practical matters. To be truthful, I am really grateful that my coming to you has not caused a riot, nor am I leaving in the middle of the night. Happily, these last few weeks have been a time to talk about the reasons I'm leaving and to talk about ministry. Like Paul, there are some physical concerns that are a part of my decision to become part of God's ministry down at Little Fork in metropolitan Rixieville, Virginia. The round trip from my home to Leesburg is about 100 miles. Like Paul, answering God's call has made me a minister on the move. When Father Daniel and I looked at it, in the first 12 months I was with you, in 7 of those months, I traveled over 1,000 miles in my 1997 Honda. However, I would not make the decision to leave St. Gabriel's and go on to another location simply because of convenience. This process took months of discernment with trusted advisors, including Canon Wingo and my own spiritual advisor, my spiritual director, whom I've been with for 7 years. I believe that God is calling me to Little Fork Episcopal Church because he has work for me to do there. And that is the reason that I'm moving on. It is important to me that you know that I learned a lot during my time here at St. Gabriel's. And it relates back to actually what we read in verse 2 of the passage we looked at today from Thessalonians, where Paul talks about, we had courage in our God to declare to you the gospel of God in spite of great opposition. St. Gabriel's has had the courage to continue to declare the gospel despite the obstacles that this congregation has faced. From you, I have learned, first, that proclaiming the gospel takes full effort. To quote from the book, Alcoholics Anonymous, half measures avail us nothing. The work of bringing people to a knowledge of the good news of Jesus Christ is just plain hard work. The really good news is that we don't labor in our own strength. God has sent us the Holy Spirit to inspire us and to guide us. We do this in community and not like a club, but as a church family. We work together in love, speaking our truth to one another in love. Second, I've learned to get down to basics. Because we live as a spiritual mass unit. For those too young to remember the TV show, a mobile army surgical hospital. I learned to focus on what was essential for delivering the message of the gospel. We may not have as much stuff as other parishes, but our treasure is invested in spreading the kingdom. And I am truly wholly proud of that. And third, I learned to keep my eyes on the prize. Slowly, over time, I learned that if what I needed to do or say was not going to keep us moving towards the goal of bringing people to Jesus Christ, then it could wait. I learned that the most important things I could contribute in word or action were about the mission of bringing the kingdom to people. And that is different than bringing people to the kingdom. Finally, I knew that I wanted to share with you from this passage because of verse 8. So deeply do we care for you that we are determined to share with you not only the gospel of God, but also our own selves, because you have become very dear to us. I came to St. Gabriel's because I knew that God had called me to come here to share in the work of ministry. I wanted to do a good job, but I had experienced some hurts in ministry before I came here that made me somewhat wary of getting close. However, over time, we built relationships, and you became very dear to me. Beloved, and I will be a better minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ because of the love that you have shown me and Evan. Evan wanted to be here this morning, and she woke up just quite sick, and we delayed leaving, but she, in the end, was just too sick to come out this morning. But she does send you her love. And so I close with these words from the end of the book of 1 Thessalonians. Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in every situation, because this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Don't suppress the Spirit. Don't brush off Spirit-inspired messages, but examine everything carefully and hang on to what is good. Avoid every kind of evil. Now, may the God of peace himself cause you to be completely dedicated to him. And may your spirit, soul, and body be kept intact and blameless at our Lord Jesus Christ's coming. The one who is calling you is faithful and will do this. Brothers and sisters, pray for us. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. Amen.
Amen. Amen.